this is Darman. Welcome to another Minecraft Let's Play video. In this video series, I'm showing you how to build Stampy's house. And in the last video, we built the big basic part of the music room, the music tower, that is. And, I don't really want to go down there. And it started raining in the last video, and I had to wait for it to stop raining and sleep and whatnot. And, and fall to my death again. The only thing I've done in between the last video and now is I added the doors. Just want to make a note, you're going to want to add them from the inside so that they're flush to the inside. Don't do it from the outside. Speaking of outside, we're going to do the top, at least the top today. I'm going to do the bottom. I hope to basically finish this today. So let's get to it. No dilly-dallying. All right. the top, there's fences that go all around, but not yet. We don't want to put them on there yet. Let's do... let's start with the water feature first. Okay, here's where it gets a little tricky for placement, but it's not too bad. Now, imagine this hole, if it went all the way up here. No, I don't... It's hard for me to imagine that, so I'm just gonna place blocks right up to the ceiling. And... okay, so it's the hole... So make a hole right there, and then just get rid of these again. Now, the reason I have you mark that is that we're going to build the back of the fountain starts right here on the back of that hole and heads this direction off the edge down to the potion brewing room. We're going to start back here. Let's see here. Okay. Let me grab my little mappy here. Okay, so we're going to put one row behind here, and then we're just going to put... Oops, not there. No. Oh, stop it. Stop it. Two more in there in the middle like that. Once we have that, we can fill this back in with sandstone. We don't want to leave that open. But we just use that as the mark for where we put the back wall of this fountain. So there's that. And then right here, let's see, catty corner to this one here, 2, 3, 4, 5. Well, I'm trying to think of how I'm going to explain this. Let's put one here. Oops, let's make that wood. Put one here with a half slab on it. Then build up four here, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you're going to work your way down just like these, but backwards. So 1.5 slabs, and then one there. So it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 total. So if you wanted, you could just put, you know, 5 blocks going across, a couple of half slabs, and then 3 more in the middle there. Like that. And we're going to do the same on the other side. So let's do it the other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's see, we're going to put half slabs here and here, and then 3 more on top of there, so it's a total of 4 high. Now this is going to be, let's see here. Let's see, 1, it's 4 here. So we're going to bring it in 1 on each side. I'm going to put a half slab on top of this one only, leave that one alone. And then the middle are 2 full blocks up here. Yep, there we go. There's going to be some torches like here and here, and the same on this side. Okay. Now, starting right here. Right with the same block, that's where we're going to start, you know, doing our little fountain that goes out this way. And this is going to be 19 blocks. So let's grab some wood. That's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Okay. Do the same here. I don't have to be quite as careful. I'm just going to come out and then find when I'm at the end of this one. Okay, so that's that. And we'll finish the bottom of this in a second. I just wanted to mark that off where that went. Now inside here, there's only a couple of ways to make the water look the way it's supposed to look from his videos. And this is the only way I've really found it. I'm not 100% sure how he does this floor down in here, but this works. So, and that is this. Hold on. Make it like kind of an I, like the capital letter I, across, like kind of like this. And that basically just leaving, this is all half slabs, leaving these two open. And trust me, you have to leave these two open, otherwise this will not work. This will just spill out all over the place and make a big mess. Now, when you place the water, just for the purposes right now, you're going to place it here and here for starters. So that's what we're going to do first. So I'm going to put it right up here and right here. Okay, and it kind of makes a sort of a nice little pattern there. Now around back, you can see there's four squares that are empty, and you're going to just put one block of water on each one, and it does that. This is how it looks on Stampy's videos, at least as far as I can remember. And now these two are also empty, so you're going to put fountains on there, and there you go. That's it. That's all I have to do for that center part. Now, right now the water is running down the wrong spot, but that's okay. We're going to fix that in just a second. Now, actually, let's just block that off for now. So let's just bring this. This is just going to be a little the bottom of the, this where the water is going to be, and we're actually going to fill this in with another row here. This is going to be two blocks deep here, three blocks wide, and then one more row right in the middle underneath. I don't know why. Do I know why he builds anything? I've not a clue. So it's going to look like kind of like this. Then we're going to take these stairs and we're going to build upside down stairs on the edges. Although we're going to have to break out, I think it's this one, I think the third one, 1, 2, 3, because the railing's going to kind of meet up in there. Oops, no, I didn't want to do that. Put some upside down stairs right over here, and then boom, there we go. I'm going to take the third one out, 1, 2, 3. And that's going to match up with the railing. So now we can release some of this water. And hey, let's fill this up and see if we got this right. This is a good test. We're not going to look yet. We're just going to fill this all up. That'll give it time to kind of find its way down there. And we'll see. We got rid of all the streams. Okay, let's see. Woo, it's going in the hole. Yay, it's going right in there perfectly. So now the water feature of the house is basically complete. It starts here, runs down here, runs through here, runs into the main area, and then down into what eventually will be the secret base down there, which we'll do. It's probably be about just about the last thing we can do. I can't build that until we build the other half of the house over here. That's just not really possible. Okay. So we know the water is working. That's good. Okay, so we need a couple of extra blocks. Oh, there's a little feature that kind of comes over here. We're going to use some half blocks, half slabs, and we're going to skip this one here. We're going to put two half slabs here on each side. And then we're going to put half slabs over it, but not all the way over like this. We want to cut the ends off so it's just like kind of hovering over the water like that. So that way if you were, it looks like little steps, you can just, hop on over like that. Now there's another additional block of wood that goes here and here. Yes. Okay, now some oak logs. There's some oak logs that go up here, and then we're going to put the fences in. Oak logs go in the middle, on the same side as like where the ladders are that go up. In fact, we might as well punch a hole in here for the that's where the access panel access is going to be. And same thing over here, right in the middle. Punch that out. And we've got ones that are here and here. So the fences will go around them once we put them in. And there's a little bench here, which is just a couple of stairs. Normally he would put like, well, he probably does actually. I just laughed because I said something, but never said it out loud. I only said it in my head. Just put the little armrests on there. There you go. A little place to sit. And as I think he said in his video, so you can stare at not much of anything over here. Anyway, let's get some fences. Where are they here? I don't think I need water anymore. And that should do it. So let's just put fences all the way around. And we'll pretty much just about be done. It's up here. We're going to put a couple of torches around and some hatches. Yeah, I don't know why this block is there, really. It does serve as a place to put a torch since we're here. That must be the best reason for it. I don't know. Let's go back to fence. Fencing. Oh, applying fences, the fenceramics of this area. This music tower, I tell you, is this one's tough. It was hard to figure out, but once I got it, I was so ecstatic. And once I really felt confident about it, that's when I felt like sharing it with you. I need a hatch. Where are the hatches now? Here we are. Don't really need any signs. Let's put a couple of. That was weird. I saw some weird pixelating artifacts or something over there. Okay, is that it up here? Okay, yep, that's it. That's it. That's it. That's all done. Okay, and that's going down there. So let's do this ledge that goes around here. Now, crinkle, crinkle, crinkle as I move my papers. Next, we're going to. Okay, let me make sure I'm oriented correctly here. All right, this is the long side, the short side. All right, let's go to the short side, which is the, there's only a short amount of blocks between here and the edge. Okay. Now on this side, we're gonna add 12 blocks of sandstone. Now, yes, right now there's only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Am I on the right? 12, is this right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Whew, 8. So we're going to add two more on the ends. And I'm going to explain all this why in a minute. So just follow my lead here. This is on the short side down here. First, just fill one row, just one of sandstone. Add two on each side. You can fill this in here. Actually, you have to fill that in there. Two out on this side, then fill this in. Okay. Now, don't do anything else yet. No, well, actually, what you want to do is add two more rows on top of that. Should be total of 3 rows coming out this way. Okay. All right, so don't do anything more. Don't try to fill this in yet over here. We're going to do the exact same thing on the opposite side over here. Fill in one row. We're going to add two and kind of fill this part in to make that even. Add two, fill this in, and stick on two more rows. One, two. So those two sides are going to be exactly the same. On this side, we want this total width to be 11, because this side is a different size. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So an even number wouldn't really work. So fill this in. That's 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 2 on each side. 8, 9, 10, 11, and fill this in. You're probably thinking in the videos, he just kind of goes around and around and around and just keeps adding on, but I couldn't figure out a good way to explain that, so I thought this was better. So we're just going to do the same thing on this side. We're just going to fill this in, add two on the ends. Just kind of fill that part in. Two on the ends, add that part. Did I do the other rows? I don't think I did. So we're going to add two rows here. The only thing different between that side, that, like, those two sides and this one is the overall length. Nope, I didn't add them on. Okay, let's just tack them on there. One row here, two rowies here. Okay, now's the easy part. Doesn't matter which side you're looking at. What we're going to do is just start, leave one block empty and start in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then next one is 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, next one is 3, 2, 1, boom. There you go. So you're just going to go to, I just like to turn to the right, and I'm going to put 5 down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Make sure you leave that one space, then go in each time. And it's just going to bring it down one number each time. So there's 4 there, 3 there, 2 there, and 1 there. It's going to do that to all the corners. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, and then 1. Now we're going to put some fences up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1. Okay, here we go. Fences, they just go all the way around, just like on the top. Oops. Missed one. Maybe I'll do it from this view. Maybe I'll do a little better job. Nope, not a better job. But maybe a better illustration of what's happening here. I feel like I'm going to hit my head on the water thing that's over. My virtual head, that is. What? You mean it's not real? Oh. Yep, I did. I bonked it. All right. I got stuck here. All right, so let's just finish this off here. And then just bring some fences down from these holes here, and they should match right up. There we go. So yeah, 1, 2, the third block is the right place. Why does he do it this way? Let's all say it together. I have no idea. But that is the way he does it. Okay, so we got the top done. We got the sides are all done. We could probably do with some more torches. I think he's got like, I want to say like, I think he's got like a torch on the end and probably like a couple more in here, something like that. Honestly, can't quite remember. That'll do. So you don't have to message me about where the torches go. You can just put them wherever you want, just so you can see well enough. So the only thing really left is this bottom part here. Whew. This is the toughest part, I will say. Speaking of torches, I'm going to put a couple torches around here. We can see what we're doing. I know he's got torches like around the bottom part here, and yes, I know we have not put the doors in yet. The doors actually go in here, whether it's three wide, not on this side, doorway goes right in here, and it's, you'll see it's, you got to go, you know, it's too thick here. Since we're in here, I might as well just show you how you're going to want to knock out these two and put torches in there as well. What do we have, doors here? All right, let's throw the doors on. I wasn't really planning on doing this part right now, but there. Now that part's done. And we're going to put some torches a little bit higher as well. I think he's got them, like, I want to say, like, up here. That'll help kind of illuminate as we go. Because even though it's daytime and I've locked it into a daytime mode, which, by the way, number one, I love. And two, I apologize, I can't remember your name, but once somebody commented on the video and said, like, you know, you can just, you know, lock that daytime cycle. And I was like, yeah, I just found that out today. And I will definitely be using that on my videos now, which is great. So this is what it looks like underneath right now. There will be a room 2 blocks high that's going to go around here, which is, I think, where he actually said originally he was going to have somebody come in and put note blocks in so that it would play like the Mario theme or something like that. But anyway, all right, so let's get the wood out. Let me flip my noisy pieces of paper to the correct, oh boy, where is it? Where is it? Oh, I feel so unprepared. Oh, here it is. I was looking right at it the whole time. Okay, here we go. All right, so we've got this sticky outy part here. All right, so we're going to make a full ring around here. By full, I mean we're going to fill in the corners as well of wood. So it's going to be, you know, a proper square like that. And then we're going to go out one more. So it's it's a 2 block square all the way around that. So this wood is going right up against that wood. Now I gotta find, okay, here's the long side out sticking out this way. Okay, so this we have to add on four. Oh, right here. Just, you know, have it match up right along with this tower part. So two rows of four. And then one row of two, like that. So there's this original one row here. And then two rows of four that are centered, and then one row of two, obviously, centered as well. Okay. Now I'm going to double this up. By that, I mean I'm just going to build another layer on top of here so that we'll be able to add the next part. Oops, getting ahead of myself there. Let's just fill this all in. So now this is like a little double thick piece. And this is the part where I kind of need to go slow here. So I'm gonna try to do this as slowly as possible. All right, so we want to do this. So confident am I. Okay. We want to add like a little L on these two. And then here, come add one here. And two again here. So we want to put the little, this is on, let me see if I can get a decent view for you. There we go. Okay. So we don't want one here for some reason. I don't know why he didn't put one there, but he didn't. Otherwise it would be just kind of like saying, like, just kind of go out one all the way around and then add two on the front. But it's this little L here, and then it goes in and it makes this kind of U, reverse U, and there's two here. I'll give you a good look. Give you a good look at this. Okay. Now, what we're going to build next is actually the floor of that little room. So like before, I'm going to add another layer up here. And it'll be easier to add on the next piece. Or should I? I'm second guessing myself here. Yeah, that's all right. We're just going to keep going with this. Fill all this in. Turn around. Get this easier this way. Okay, so all I did is just put another layer on, so this is too thick. Two layers thick. Three, well, I guess it's... Oh, back here it's three. So, well, that would be helpful, Dave. If I could actually finish this part over here. So this sticky out, this part here where I had to do a little L and this part sticks out here, what we want to do is this should go all the way around once. That's why I was confusing myself. Yeah, just like that. Because the whole thing should basically just wrap around all the way around once, but except for the exception of these corners, is going to be, you know, empty, and then you stick these two on there. So I've got to double that up now that I've added that should have been there in the first place. Okay. So this, I'm on the back, I'm on the short side right now. So this goes up here and it steps out one here. So we're going to add one more row to the back of this. And then we're going to go out one on each side. Stay with me on this. And then we're going to go back to the front. We're going to add two to the front like that. And this is basically going to be a big square that we're going to connect now. Like these two things here. We're going to connect, and then we're going to add on to it afterwards. But for right now, we're just going to connect these two. Same thing over here. We can bring this kind of over, too far. Fill this in. I need a little light here. Boink. Okay. So now I've got this rectangle sitting on top of this. And all we have to do is on the sides, you know, on the part that runs along this way, we're going to add two more rows, but each row is going to be shorter than the last by one block. So just do it that way, and the second row, one block in like that, and same on the other side. Leave the ends open and just fill this in. Lastly, and that's it. That's the floor of the actual underneath room. Now, this is where it gets a little bit tricky. We're going to have to do some upside down work to make this work right. First, we need to put a layer of oak all the way around the outside. Just all the way around. Oops. Not there. And when we go, once we get done this thing, you can go back to the tutorial on Xbox if you're on Xbox. Or maybe they have the same one on PS3. I don't know. And see how this compares to their tower. I think you're going to find that this one is a little bit better. So we want to go, we've gone once around everywhere, and then we want to add one more layer around. So I'm going to do the corners first, kind of like what we did on top. On the top of the this here tower, do the corners, and then I'm going to fill them in. I don't want to fill on the edges first because I want to make sure I get these. I might get confused by the part that's right here. If I put all this in, I might get confused about where to put these corner ones because I'm not that bright sometimes. Okay, did I double that one up already? Okay, so now I can just put my second row around the outside. Basically, we want it two rows of oak all the way underneath this upper rim part here. Now, the area that's left in here is, if I can illustrate this way, is one block tall, but needs to be made out of sandstone. And this is where it gets a little tricky. I'm just going to put one here temporarily just so that I can, there should be a space in between here. Don't build it all the way up here. Maybe it's easier. Well, I don't know. I'll do it this way. I'm just going to go around here. Double that one up. So now you'll see there's no more space showing here. This should be too wide. And then don't put one here. Don't go like that. You don't want this to be touching the outside like that. Just gonna fill in that way. There we go. And we could do it this way if you want. Just fill that in. Okay, I'm gonna stop there. Fill that in. This in, you don't want to have a piece of wood above your sandstone like that, so just take your time. This is a technique he uses in several builds as far as, you know, building out and up. Okay, here we go, around here. Last time around the corner, and there we go. Wow, there it is. That's how it looks from underneath. If you look in his videos, that is what you're gonna find. It's weird, I'll grant you that, but it's majestic and unique. And that says a lot. Okay, there is that done? No, you know what? We got a couple little details in here, don't we? You'll notice it gets kind of dark up here in this here tunnel. So he's got about midway up, he's got a torch. And I'm gonna where did my Here we go. Okay, from the top, it's near as I can tell, it's 8 down. 9. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's hard to see which. Blocks are getting lit up here. Let's try it this way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9th block on each side. Just gonna put a torch in there. And that helps. Oops, not quite like that. There we go. Oh, do I don't know. Does he do it like that or like this? Oh, that's a good question. Well, I kind of like that. We'll do that. All right, some details inside. Now, right here on each side of this entrance is going to be a full block. It's drippy. And then take some half slabs and just put two in front and two in the back. There you go. You don't put them on the corners here. And there's going to be torches on each side of that. We also need a jukebox, since this was supposed to be a music room. And just make sure I'm putting it in the right place. Let's see, jukebox. Oh, here we go. Jukebox. Put that there. We need it in chest. Put that there. All right, the jukebox. Let's see here. Okay. If you are coming up the ladder and you come out, the jukebox and chest are going to be to your right. The chest is going to be here, and the jukebox is going to be here. Okay? So again, if you're coming up the ladder, turn right, and that's where you put those. Now, if you turn left, right over here in this corner is going to be a little hatch for getting down into this room, which is very dark. Looks something like this right now. Now you can just throw some torches around here. And he's also got some, like, kind of like in the corners here. Whatever amount of torches he has is not enough, because if you watch the 2,000 subscriber video, he's like, oh yes, right down here is this room, and standing, like, wherever this hatches, standing right here is this big fat creeper coming over, like, hey buddy. So right in the middle of his video, he dies, and he's like, really? Anyway, that's one of the most hilarious parts of the videos, in my opinion. So we need to back this. We're going to put a ladder right here. So right on this hatch, just fill it in two blocks wide there, and then for some reason, he's got one more each over here. I'm not sure what that's about. I do not question Stampy. I just follow. Maybe that's not such a smart idea in general for life. So just put some ladders there. And that's this room done. As far as I know, nothing else is down here. If you know that he's put anything down here, let me know in the comment section. And if possible, let me know which video you are should look at to do that. So we've got some torches here. We've got these decorated, and this here, and we've got already put the doors up. We've got this thing running. The water's going down there perfectly. I think we're done. Are we done? Could it be? I always do that, and then I'm like, oh, I forgot this and that. All right, seriously, let me take a quick look. We should probably, I think we have to put torches on these here. That kind of makes sense. Need some light up here. Okay. I think he's got some more torches, like, I want to say, like, here, like, not there, like, on the corners. He tends to put them on the corners of things. But you can watch his videos to see where you want to put torches. That's getting into a level of detail which I think you can handle on your own. For my purposes, I'm just going to do it now that I've already started it. I might as well just go ahead and do that. There we go. Okay. Probably need couple of torches. I think he's got one, like, I want to say, like, here and here, something like that, just to kind of illuminate the underside a bit. There's probably, I think there's some, like on the back corners or something like that. Anyway, you can have fun figuring out where the torches go and And there you go. Wow. So there it is. In all its glory, the music tower. Whew. With absolutely no music playing whatsoever. The most inaccurately named piece of architecture in Stampy's world, the music tower. I'm Darman68. Thanks for watching these few videos to get this music tower built. And I'll see you next time. Bye!